Let's phrase it this way. When you're sitting down with the person that's gonna recruit you into their network marketing business, you say, Mr. Joe, can I become successful financially just selling the product? No recruiting. It's a yes or no question. Straightforward. It's a yes or no question. Most of the time, many companies, compensation plans I looked at, leaning on the no side. Why? Because network marketing companies are designed typically to build people, recruit people, right? Typically. Very few network marketing companies have the option where you can be a builder, a recruiter, or just a producer. Where you're like, dude, I don't care about recruiting. I don't want to recruit people. I'm not into that. That's not me. And let's say you're a really good sales guy or a saleswoman. You're like, you just love the product and you want to tell the world about it. Great. Can he or she be successful financially just selling the product? If you get a yes, that means that particular network marketing company gives you the option of two. You can be a producer or a recruiter, or you can be both. So really three options, right? Those companies are very, very unique and hard to come by. And I believe, based on my research, I found two so far. I think there's some others out there, but I found two so far. So a compensation plan that rewards producers is a nice indicator. It makes me feel safe because I don't have to recruit if I don't want to make a lot of money. I don't have to recruit. I can just sell personal volume. That means I'm not reliant on other people to do the work for me. It's about my performance. So that means my paycheck is directly correlated to the amount that I perform. And when I look at the commissions on every product that gets sold, I look at that and I times it by 100 customers, 150 customers, 500 customers, however many customers it takes to make multiple or break past six figures, right? So the way I answer the question, in my mind, the follow-up, if they say yes, you can become successful just producing by selling the product, my follow-up question is, how many customers do I have to sell to make six figures, right? How many customers do I have to sell to make six figures, right? So when I look at that, I'm like, all right, let's say you're selling a high-end product and the commission out the gate when you start off is maybe $300 and then it caps out at maybe $600, right? So you could take 100 grand and divide it by $300, you would need to acquire 333 clients. To me, that's not bad at all. In the last 3 years, I've accumulated over 1,000 clients in my business, and that resulted in over $1 million in revenue. It's not bad at all, right? So that means the average, you know, if we just went off 1,000, I know it's a little, let me do 1,100. So if I made $1 million in the last 3 years and I accumulated 1,100 clients, my average lifetime value, ALV, my average lifetime value of each and every client that comes through my door is $909. This is my business, right? Okay, great. When I look at a network marketing company, success to me is breaching over 100K because that's 2X the average income in America. So as long as I 2X it and then anything above that, then you hit market dominance and then it takes off from there. But if it takes me, say, 1,500 customers, over 1,000 customers just to make 100 grand, that's very hard to do, right? Think about it. $100,000 divided by 1,000 clients, that's only $100 per client. I think you're better off, you know, go get a 4-year degree education at college and work for a tech company, Google, and make over six figures. You know, be a doctor, be a lawyer, be a CPA, an accountant, a financial consultant, and make over $100,000, $200,000, and maybe have half that, 500 or less clients. So this is another way. You're taking notes, you're asking the question, when you sit down with that individual, you say, okay, can I become successful financially just selling the product? They say yes. Your follow-up question is, how many customers does it take to make six figures? Through that, they say 1,000, 900. Then all you have to do is take 100 grand, divided by the amount of customers required, and then you see the follow-up. You do in your math and you say, okay, how much time, effort required does it take to acquire customer acquisition, to acquire the customer? What's the cost to acquire the customer and how much time? If you end up with a scenario where your customer acquisition cost is like 30% of $100 and then it takes you 3 hours to acquire the customer, well, then you do, say the example of $100 is the result to make six figures, 1,000 clients, $100 per client. Your customer acquisition costs, say it's $20, so minus 80, and then it takes you 3 hours to acquire the client. $80 divided by three, you're making $26 an hour. Now, if you're a career type of a guy, white collar, blue collar, and you drive trucks for a living, you make $35 an hour driving trucks, aren't you better off continuing to drive trucks than to look at this type of a model? That's something to think on. Or you might say, I'm willing to do that because it aligns with my mission and value. Then okay, cool. But I like to look at it from a numbers perspective. Is this profitable according to how I'm currently making money? Does it breach? So let's say it was, you know, in order to make $100,000, you had to do 350 customers. So that means your average lifetime value of that customer is $285 per customer. And your acquisition cost was $35. So minus 35 bucks, you're at 250. And it takes you 4 hours to acquire one customer. You're making $62 an hour. Not bad, not bad. Now, what's the likelihood of you obtaining 350 customers in the first year? Very unlikely, right? Let's just be real. Very unlikely. Now, can it be done? Absolutely. The likelihood, very low. So let's go with the statistics, the stats. How long, this is now personal, you and me, how long am I willing to play that game to acquire 350 customers to make six figures and then continue to make six figures moving forward? I like to look at it from a 5 to 10 year, I'm not even gonna say 5 year, I say 7 to 10 year time frame when looking at network marketing to produce multiple six figures. 7 to 10 years minimal to produce multiple six figures. You might accumulate six figures in the first 5 years, but you made 20 grand, 30 grand, 10, 25, that's different. I'm talking your first 100 grand in 1 year might take you 7 to 10 years if you're someone with no sales experience, no marketing experience, no business experience, like you're lacking that. I like to be very, very realistic.